Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss one numerical which is related to concepts of mass moment of inertia. As we have discussed lot of concepts related to mass moment of inertia, so we will use all the formulas, all the derivations and all the concepts which is related to mass moment of inertia to solve this particular numerical. So let's start the numerical here. And the numerical is, a body consists of solid hemisphere of radius 5 cm and a right circular cone of height 15 cm. The hemisphere and the cone have a common base and made of same material. Locate the position of CG on the composite body. So this is the numerical which is related to composite body. So here we have two solids. One is solid hemisphere and another is solid circular cone. So here we have a composite body which is made of a solid hemisphere and one cone. So this is our solid hemisphere and this is our solid circular cone. And the dimensions of both the composite bodies are given here. For the solid hemisphere, the radius is given. It is 5 cm. So this is our hemisphere. So this particular radius is given. It is 5 cm. And we have a right circular cone of height 15 cm. So the height of the solid circular cone is 15 cm. It is given in this particular diagram. And the radius of the solid hemisphere is 5 cm. So we are considering the base of this particular hemisphere as the base of the solid cone. So both the solids are sharing common base. So the dimension for the base of this particular hemisphere and the dimension for the base of this solid circular cone is same. So we can say the radius of the solid circular cone is equal to 5 cm only as per this particular diagram. Now let's read the another terms. The hemisphere and cone have a common base. So as I told you, so the dimensions will be same and it is made of same material. So this particular solid hemisphere, if we are considering this as a body 1 and the cone we are considering as a body 2. So both the solids or bodies are having same material, means density of both the solids will be same. Here, so both the densities, if we are considering raw 1 and raw 2, so raw 1 and raw 2 will be equals to raw. So density we will consider here same. If we want to find out the mass, so mass we can find out as density into volume. So here in this particular case, for both the bodies, here we will consider same material. Now, we have to locate the position of CG on this composite body. So here we have to find out the center of gravity position for this composite or combined body, combination of solid hemisphere and this solid circular cone. And first of all, we have to locate here the CG of each solid for the hemisphere and for the solid circular cone. Or when we are taking a composite body, so for composite body there will be a separate CG. So here what we will do, we will find out the CG of the cone and CG of the hemisphere. Then on the basis of those both CGs of different solid, we will find out a common CG for a composite body. And with the help of concept of mass and with the help of concept of volume, we will solve this particular numerical. So let's start the solution. So as you can see, this is the diagram we are taking, and here we are considering A, B, C as the solid circular cone and B, C, D as the solid hemisphere, and B, C we are considering as the common base. The dimensions are given, so let's start the solution. So here we have to find out First, the mass of each solid or mass of the composite body. Here we have to find out the value of Cg for the composite body. And to find out the composite body Cg or center of gravity, we need the distances of Cg for the separate bodies and the mass. Or in place of mass, we can use the volume also. Volume for each solid. So first of all, we will apply the concept of mass. As we know, mass equals to density into volume, and density is common for both the solid, but we don't have the exact value of density because exact material is not given. So here we will use the volume for each solid, and we will find out the volume for the solid circular cone and for the hemisphere. So if we are considering for this particular solid circular cone, the volume is V1, and here first of all we will mark the Cg for the solid circular cone. So that Cg we will mark as G1. Here you can see this is the point, and this particular point we are considering as G1 for the solid circular cone. You can see in this particular diagram we are considering A as the apex and BC as the base. So for the solid circular cone, we are considering G1 as the center of gravity, and for this hemisphere we are considering G2 as the center of gravity. G we are considering the center of gravity for the composite body. Now here we have to find out first of all the volume of each solid. We want to find out the volume for this particular solid circular cone ABC. Here A we are considering as the apex. So we will apply the formula of volume of the cone. So if we want to find out the volume for this solid circular cone, so here we are considering the formula, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h. And as we know, here both the solids are sharing common base. So the radius we are denoting with small r. So this radius of the solid circular cone will be equivalent to the radius of the hemisphere, that is 5 centimeters. So we will put here 1 by 3 pi into 5 square, and height of the cone is given 15 centimeters. So it will be 1 by 3 pi into 5 square into 15. Now we will solve this particular equation and we will get the value of volume. So it is 392.5 centimeter cube, because all the dimensions are given in centimeter. Now we will find out the position of G for this particular cone. So it is given by G1. So here we will find out the value of G1, but first of all we have to define one reference point. So let us take the apex as the reference point, and with respect to this reference point, apex point A, we will find out all the Cgs. Cg for the solid circular cone, Cg for the hemisphere, as well as Cg for the composite body. So this apex A we are considering as the reference point. So let's find out the value of G1 or the position of Cg for the solid circular cone with respect to apex or from apex. Let us consider the distance of this particular apex and the G1, that is the center of gravity for the solid circular cone, is Y1. So here we are denoting Y1 as the distance of Cg of the solid circular cone from the apex. So we will apply the concept, and it will be this particular distance G1 we will consider from the base of the cone, but here we have to find out the Cg value from the apex. So it will be 15, or the height, minus this particular height. So it will be always h by 4. So the value of Y1 will be minus 15 by 4. This will be total height. here we are considering this particular y1 up to g1 from A. So this y1 we will get from 15 minus this particular height, that is 15 by 4 from the base of the cone. So it will be 11.25 centimeters. So here we have the value of y1. Now the first, this particular solid cone is solved. Now we have to move towards this solid hemisphere. As you can see, this hemisphere we are considering as BCD. B, C and D. And the CD of this solid hemisphere we are considering G2. It is given here, G2 is the CD of this hemisphere. So first of all, we will find out the volume of this hemisphere, then we will find out the position of this particular G2 from the apex. Here we will consider apex as the reference point. So we have to find out the location of G2 from the apex only. For both the cases, we will consider one reference point only or common reference point only, that is the apex. So from apex, we will find out the position of G2 for the hemisphere. So first of all, let's find out the value of volume. As we know, the volume of the sphere is always equivalent to 4 by 3 pi r cube. This is the volume of the sphere. But here we are considering hemisphere. So it will be half of the volume of the sphere. So it will be 1 by 2, 4 by 3 pi r cube. And r we know it is 5 centimeter given. So we will put the value of r. Then we will get the value of V2. Now the value of V2 we have after solution will get 261.67 centimeter cube. So we have the value of V2. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out the position of G2 from the apex. So let us consider the distance of this G2 from point A is Y2. So here we have to define the value of Y2. Now we have the value of this particular height. We have the height of the cone, which is we are considering from the point A. So up to point A to this particular midpoint or this particular point, this point, we have the dimension that is 15 centimeter and we have to find out rest of the distance only. So it will be 15 plus this particular distance. And this distance we generally consider as the position of CG for the hemisphere from the base of the hemisphere. So we will apply the concept. So here the value of Y2, 15 plus 3 by 8 of R. Here 3 by 8 of R is representing the exact location of center of gravity for the hemisphere from the base. So here we will find out this particular value and then we will add the value of H from the apex. So we will get the final value of Y2, that is the location of G2 from the reference point A. So the value of Y2 we have 16.875 centimeter. So this value we have, this is representing the location of G2. Now we have the volume of this hemisphere and we have the location of G1 for the cone and the volume of the solid circular cone. Now we have to find out the location of center of gravity for the composite body. So here we are considering the location of CG for the composite body is G. And this particular location we will find out from the same reference point, that is the apex point. So from point A, we will find out the location or exact distance of CG of the composite body. So here, let us consider the distance of this G from the apex point is Y bar. So this y bar value we have to find out from the reference point. And as per the concept of moment of inertia and as per the concept of center of gravity for the particular body which is having mass or which is having volume or which is having weight, we can apply this particular formula. So the formula we can apply on the basis of volume and the location of CGs, it will be V1 Y1 plus V2 Y2 divided by V1 plus V2. And here we have all the values, so we can easily get the value of Y bar. So here, if we put all these value of V1 Y1, V2 Y2 divided by V1 plus V2, so we will get the final value of Y bar, that is 13.49 centimeter from the apex point A. So here we can locate the position of center of gravity for the composite body with the help of value of Y bar. Or we can also locate the CG of the composite body from the base of this particular hemisphere. So in any case, if we have all the dimensions, we can easily locate the position of CG for the separate bodies or for the composite body. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.